Morning and welcome to the New Hampshire Insurance's webinar on creating a home inventory. I'm Andrew Demers. I am the communications director here, and I'm happy to be joined by our deputy commissioner, DJ Bettencourt, and our consumer services director, Keith Nyhan. If you have any questions during this webinar, we're happy to address those at the end. So please use the chat window to type your questions in, and we'll address those at the end. Now to kick things off, I'm happy to turn it over to our Deputy Commissioner, DJ Bettencourt.
Thank you, Andrew, and good morning. As Andrew mentioned, my name is DJ Bettencourt. I have the pleasure of serving as the Deputy Commissioner of the New Hampshire Insurance Department, and I want to thank you all for joining us for this month's webinar. As I've mentioned in the past, the department receives approximately 5,000 consumer calls per year. Of those calls, some of the most emotionally difficult cases that we see involve the loss of a home or significant damage to a home because of a fire or other disaster. And we've heard stories of decades and sometimes centuries of memories and valuables being lost in an instant because of that incident. It is understandable that none of us wants to think about something like that happening to us. Unfortunately, it does happen. And as a result, consumers need to be proactive to protect themselves and make the insurance process as smooth as possible in that very difficult situation. Part of that protection involves making an inventory of the valuables in your home, which will ensure that you are getting the best benefit and protection under your insurance policy. And so to get into the details of that process and how to do it right, I'm joined by my colleague, the head of our consumer division, Keith Nyhan. Keith.
Thank you very much, Commissioner. And I will kind of pick up where everybody left off, which is, on behalf of Commissioner Nicolopoulos and Commissioner Bettencourt and all of those of us here at the Insurance Department, I want to thank you for joining us on our webinar today. My name is Keith Nyhan. I am the Director of the Consumer Services Unit. I have been here at the department for almost 16 years, and prior to that, I served in the industry for more than 12. So I have about 28, 30 years of experience in the insurance industry, and looking forward to talking to you today. So today I wanted to speak about the importance of completing a home inventory, and I also want to touch base upon the importance of periodically shopping your insurance coverage. Not going to be a long webinar today, certainly encourage questions, but just do a quick overview of what we do here at the insurance department first. The department's mission is to basically protect the insurance markets of the state of New Hampshire, protect insurance consumers. More specifically, and I apologize here, I'm just going to read the actual mission of the department. Promote and protect the public good by ensuring the existence of a safe and competitive insurance marketplace through the development and enforcement of the insurance laws of the state of New Hampshire. For its part, the Consumer Services Division is threefold. Educate, navigate, and investigate. And those three components are, as Commissioner Bettencourt mentioned, we take about 5,000 calls a year. Most of those calls are relative to education. We're going to talk more about that in this webinar, but we educate consumers about the products, the insurance industry as a whole, the companies that issue those products, many times the producers. And equally important, we help consumers who are having difficulty navigating the insurance industry do so efficiently. And typically, those type of navigation exercises are someone who's trying to find health insurance, somebody who's having difficulty processing a claim or receiving claim benefits, or somebody maybe who's going through the underwriting process. So navigation is a key part of what we do. And then lastly, the investigative component of the Consumer Services Division is to take consumer grievances, contact our licensees, and make sure that there are no violations of insurance laws and regulations. Which, by the way, is probably a good transition for us to now move back over into that education component. Relative to that education, today we're going to talk about the importance of completing a home inventory, as well as periodically shopping one's insurance coverage. So let's start off with a basic question of what is a home inventory? As the moniker suggests, it's literally an inventory or accounting of personal items of value that an insured has in his or her home, apartment, or even rental or storage unit. this list could be something that's done in writing. It could be a video. It could be any number of mediums to record what those items are. Why is it important? There are certain types of insurance losses where the insureds will be asked to provide a list of items, including their value and age, that were damaged or stolen during a particular insurance loss. And those insurance products that we're really talking about here are homeowners insurance, renters insurance, and storage unit policies. Losses that were typically would require the submission of an inventory would be a fire loss, whether it be partial or total, flood damage or flood losses, again, partial or total, and in some cases, burglary. As you can imagine, trying to remember, you know, what one has or has had in his or her home, which has been lost, during a period of great stress can be challenging and incredibly difficult. As an example, 2 to 3 years ago, we helped an insured who had lost everything, I shouldn't say everything, quite a bit of personal property due to theft. And the person was under a great deal of stress, and frankly, the time period for submitting a claim relative to those losses was coming to an end. I think it was 2 years, might have been 3 years, and the individual just could not compel herself to sit down and think through what items she had lost. It's difficult remembering. So, you know, we were able to help her here at the department. We reached out to the insurance company and actually facilitated an extension and spoke with this individual about some ideas as to how she could think about and how she could, you know, in her own mind, try to capture what was lost. We also worked with the company to be a little more lenient in what that list looked like. But this delay took approximately, as I said, 2 to 3 years, which delayed a $15,000 settlement that she could have used to get herself back on track and to alleviate some of that stress that she was experiencing. Had a home inventory existed, it could have produced immediate results and, you know, certainly facilitated more timely settlement of that claim. So let's talk a minute about what is in the home inventory. And as I said, it's a list of personal items of value, which ideally includes a description of the item. And if you're thinking electronics or even something more tangible, it's make, model, brand, serial number of a particular item. It could be photographs that have value to you. It could be home weapons. It could be dishes. It could be any sort of memento. So anything that's of personal value, there should be a list. And again, what's that item worth? Most carriers also want to see the date of approximate purchase and the amount paid for that item. A receipt is ideal in these situations. So how is a home inventory completed? Well, there are different generations are going to use and navigate to different means for creating their list. Certainly, in its most simple form, it could be something in writing on a notepad. A little bit more, you know, complex or more technologically savvy, someone might want to use an Excel spreadsheet. And then more recently, there's been the advent of the smartphone apps, which facilitate the creation of a home inventory, and there are many benefits to that. Here at the insurance department, we do typically recommend the NAIC's Home Inventory app, which is available in Apple's App Store or the Google Play Store, and there are many others as well. I tried an app recently called Homebook, which also was very helpful. Each of these applications that I just mentioned does allow the individual to take pictures of the items in his or her home, to record in a very logical, formatted way where that item is located, whether it be in a bedroom, a kitchen, a garage. If there's a sub-storage unit within that home, say a file cabinet, you can record that it's in the file cabinet, take a picture of the item, as well as include some important details. Also allows the individual to take snapshots of receipts if they're available. It's an excellent way to actually create an inventory, not just because of the ease and with which we use smartphones these days, but it also allows the individual to store that list to the cloud or an electronic means that wouldn't necessarily be lost in a home fire or a flood. So to that point, if someone is using a traditional notepad or paper files, store that home inventory somewhere other than your home. Bring it to your parents' house, a sibling's house, or even a friend's house, so that that list will be available when the time arises. How often should someone complete a home inventory? It's a great question. Ideally, you know, I suggest everyone, if you haven't done so, complete a home inventory today or this weekend. Once the home inventory is created, in an ideal world, you maintain that inventory every time something of value comes into the home or leaves the home. Other than that, if that's not quite your style, we recommend that you update that home inventory list at least annually. On or around the time period of your policy renewal is always a good time to do that as a reminder. And this is probably a good segue to talk about something else that's very important here for consumers to protect themselves, which is what else can a consumer do annually? Well, to kind of set this up, one of the other questions that we frequently receive here at the insurance department is, hey, my premiums are going up. What can I do about it? One of the most fundamental things that consumers can do, and consumers do have choice, is periodically shopping one's insurance coverage. Even if you like your agent or your company, you kind of owe it to yourself to reach out to the agent and company and ask if there are new financial benefits in place, if there are new policies that have been developed. Or maybe there's different coverage that is more appropriate to your current situation. We've found there are very few, if any, loyalty rewards for a consumer to stay with the same company. Might even be time that you want to look to a different company. As an example, a few years ago, I actually shopped my own coverage. I had a couple of young teenage drivers coming on board. My company added the drivers and my premiums jumped significantly, as you might imagine. So I took it upon myself, contacted my local agent who I've used for, you know, about two decades, and asked the agent to shop my coverage. The agent actually came back with some information that was actually quite surprising, which is, hey, Keith, you're actually with a very good company right now, one that we'd prefer to do business with, and you have the lowest premiums available. I said, well, that's kind of interesting. It's not what I expected. So I went back to the agent and said, could you please shop my coverage as if I'm a new consumer? And lo and behold, a couple of days later, the insurance agent contacted me and said, having shopped the coverage with the exact same company I had been with as a new consumer, with very few changes in coverage, just, you know, substantively and materially identical, I saved $800. So a couple of good reminders here, what we're driving at today. What can consumers do to proactively protect themselves? Number one, create that home inventory so that at times of loss, you don't have to, you know, think and contemplate as to what might have been lost. And secondly, shop your coverage annually. That's it for my webinar today. I certainly want to open it up to questions, comments, and I'm happy to respond to anything that you have.
Would appreciate it if you could name those apps again. Keith, the apps you're using to do the home inventory.
Absolutely. The first and foremost one that we recommend is the NAIC's Home Inventory app. Easily recognizable, has some fairly decent ratings, about 3-star rating on the Google Play Store. And the other one was Homebook, H-O-M-E, capital B-O-O-K, all one word, which I also found in the Google Play Store. I've also been told that FEMA has a nice app to do home inventories. I was unable to locate it. I suspect I have the wrong nomenclature, but again, Homebook and the NAIC's Home Inventory app are excellent. The benefits of the Home Inventory app put out by the NAIC is it also contains additional information about how to file a claim and some key parts of what that claim process looks like.
Turn it back over to Deputy Commissioner Bettencourt for some closing remarks.
Well, thank you so much. Once again, thank you all for joining us at this month's webinar. We really do hope that they are of value to you. For those who would like to come back and perhaps review this webinar, it will be on our YouTube page. It'll obviously also be available to folks who were not able to make it for the live event, but do want to watch it later. We will be back next month. And Andrew, if you wouldn't mind, do you happen to know what our subject will be next month?
Absolutely. Next month, we will be talking about total loss of your vehicle. And I think Keith will probably participate in that, as well as our subject matter expert from our property and casualty department, Doug Reese. So it's a subject near and dear to Doug's heart. And Keith, I think you deal with that somewhat. So we might ask you to play second fiddle there and back Doug up on that one.
Yeah, without question, as a teaser for that webinar, I can tell you that the number one complaint that we receive here at the insurance department concerns automobile claims. And total losses are a frequent topic of discussion. So I look forward to seeing everybody next month.
Yeah, I'm sure that'll be a popular webinar. Well, we appreciate everyone joining us. And again, this will be available on our YouTube, as well as all of our videos in our webinar series. So be sure to check that out. And we'll look forward to seeing everyone next month. Thanks very much for joining us.